What's going on, people? It's your boy Charlie in the Box, the Patriot Miscreant, over here at downtown Fresno, California, at this month's Art Hop. The first Thursday of each and every month, we have this event called Art Hop in downtown Fresno, and a lot of people come out here and have a lot of fun. Well, I want to ask them the question, how they feel about the mass migration of illegal immigrants on the southern tip of our border. And us living in California, we're a sanctuary state, where Trump threatened to send these migrants to sanctuary cities and states. Well, I'm concerned about that. I don't like it. I don't want them here. And I want to ask my people, my community, how if they feel the same or how they feel about it. So let's check it out. Okay, look at today, right now, there's anywhere from 2,000 to 2,500 illegal immigrants coming to the southern tip of our border.
Oh, really?
Seeking asylum. In the month of February, there were 70,000 of them. In the month of March, 100,000. They're estimating 1.5 million throughout the whole year. Mm-hmm. Trump just said he was going to start putting these people on buses to sanctuary states and cities. California's a sanctuary state. Do you have any concerns about that?
Well, yeah, I mean, cool, because, you know, that the thing he was doing before, like, that shit was, like, he was, like, putting them in, like, concentration camps. That
Those
shit was
videos
crazy.
Were under Obama. That wasn't under Trump.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
The ones when they're when the tinfoil blankets, when they're in the tinfoil blankets with the gates, that was under Obama. The media lied to the people about that.
Yeah. I don't keep up with politics. Yeah. It's just what I saw.
Well, I know most people don't. How do you
welcome?
Feel about that? You're welcome.
Bring them in.
Okay. How many?
That's all we got here. I'm a child of an immigrant, first generation. My parents migrated here for a better dream, and I'm living the life.
Were you born in over there?
I was
or here?
Born here.
Okay, okay.
My parents were born there.
Okay, that's good.
I don't think we should be concerned at all because we already have a high quantity of illegal immigrants in California, and it's really no harm, no foul. You know, honestly, they take care of their families. They do it. They're coming here to take care of their families. They're coming here to take care of their own. They're not coming here to infiltrate your system. They're not coming here to hurt the almighty white man, which is some crazy bullshit. That's a whole nother conversation. I don't mean to cuss. I don't know if cussing is.
No, you can say whatever you want.
Yeah, and I mean, what it really is, if we take the politics out of it for one second, and we think if you were a person from a place that is not so, I don't mean this against Mexico, I don't mean this against any anywhere, but if you're from a place and you see a land that has a greater opportunity than where you're from and your current surroundings, and you see an easy access way to get there for yourself, to provide for yourself, then why would you not take that? Regardless, I don't care if you're a Democrat, I don't care if you're I don't care what you believe in, that's just how it is. And that's what it always will be. Whether you could build the biggest wall in the fucking world, they'll find it. Hey, tell them that we need the immigrants. Tell them that we love the immigrants. Hey, tell them fuck Trump.
My long lost homie right here, bro.
Fuck Trump, bro.
No, not at all. Because illegal immigrants are my family. Illegal immigrants are the people who have brought me up. Illegal immigrants are the people who actually contribute to the economy. Illegal immigrants are not on welfare. Illegal immigrants are not on WIC. Illegal immigrants are actually contributing. No, whatever you say is not going to help me believe that, because my family has never been on welfare and they're illegal immigrants.
Okay, Trump just said he's going to start busing these people in of tens of thousands. How many are you willing to let live with you until they get off their feet? They're not going to be able to work. They're not going to be able to support them and feed their families. How many are you willing to take in? They're not going to be able to get a job. How many are you
they
willing
to work in the fields? My family worked in the fields. They've all been undocumented. They've worked in the fields and they've made money. My family's undocumented. Have their people in the farms have paid for my school. They have all done that. They're farmers. They have all done that. And why, in fact, would you say that they're not able to work? Yeah, I'll let five. I'll let as much fit in my house, work, live with me, if that's what it boils down to. I'm not afraid to let illegal immigrants come in this country asking for asylum. I'm not the person to let people fine people asking for asylum. I'm not going to charge them a fee to come into my country, because if this really is the land of the free and the land of people that are actually immigrants, I'm not going to let that happen. I will let them come to my country, and I will let them live in my house.
How many are you willing to take into your home and take care of until they get on their feet?
Why would I have to take care of them?
Well, where are they going to live and where are they going to stay?
There's multiple places they can live, and that's not my house.
Yeah, I know, but
that's 100% fact. There's so many other places than my house that immigrants can go.
Where do you think they should go house these people that are coming in? They don't got
I'm sure they would rather be here, and they can find refuge in the streets. and they would be happier with that.
But then if they're
earning money, they could go earn money in the fields.
It's like the same thing with the homeless. You don't think there's a problem with homeless at each and every one of the corners nowadays? Well, now do you want more people on those corners?
Yeah, but look how fast humans build. Look how fast humans build. Do you not think with the way current human progression is going that everyone's going to be intermixed and intertwined in a matter of decades?
Okay, so here, how many... Yeah, yeah.
Wow, how, do you make $1 billion a year to be on his side? Because I don't understand that.
Join us, come on. Seriously. Join the conversation.
Okay. Okay.
You know, Trump don't care about you.
Uh-huh.
Right. Anyone.
Yeah.
Anyone but himself. He's a fake billionaire that's stole money from people.
Yeah.
People like you.
But he's a self-made man.
No, he's not a self-made man.
Thank you.
Thank
you. I appreciate you.
Yeah. Mexico's a democracy.
Yes.
Canada's a democracy.
Correct.
America is what?
A democracy.
No, America is a republic.
But we're a democracy.
What's the difference between America but being a republic and Mexico being a democracy? Can you tell me the difference between
you can't twist that. That's we're a democracy.
No, I'm just trying to understand.
But that doesn't make sense. You're trying to twist reality. The reality is we're a democracy.
Reality is America is a republic, not a democracy. Right now, America has 25% of Mexico's population in it right now.
And what's wrong with
what's
that?
What's the difference?
But what's wrong with that? I'm going to own this conversation right now. What is wrong with that?
What's the difference between Mexico and America?
There is.
If not that border.
Yeah, because they're seeking asylum.
Yeah.
We're not going to do that. We're going to let them seek asylum. And we're not going to charge them a fee to come into our
country. Have you ever heard of the cloud and pivot strategy?
No, tell me about it.
The cloud and pivot strategy is a way to overwhelm the system. They already did with American people on welfare and on WIC, on food stamps.
Okay, but let me just ask you one question before you're talking.
Well, they're going to start...
Let me ask you one question. When you see a bum on the side of the road, have you ever seen a Mexican?
But, okay, right now, are you working?
Yeah, I'm working.
You're working.
Yeah.
Say if you lose your job, but then you got another 10,000 illegal immigrants, they just bust in tomorrow. They're going to want to work. Who do you think should be able to get that job? Them, because they just want to support the family and come to make ends meet? Or should you get that job first? You're documented and they're not.
That's a hard question.
Because I'm putting, this is reality.
Yeah, I mean, you're right.
Truth.
Yeah.
Because eventually, they're going for the same jobs. They're not in the fields no more.
Yeah.
They're not in the fields no more.
Yeah.
They're in construction. They're in warehouses. They're looking for the jobs, dishwashers. So you're not concerned about that. But see, the thing about it is, the media doesn't do their due diligence to properly educate the public to understand the severity of those
issues. Yeah, no, I agree with that. You're saying? For sure. Because I'm not informed on anything.
Have you ever heard of the cloud and pivot strategy?
No.
The cloud and pivot strategy is a way to overwhelm the system. And that's what they did. And you know, in our community, I went to grocery stores and I have asked them this question. And you go, because you live in this community, ask them this. Out of 10 people on a regular basis, how many use EBT? And you know what it is?
A lot.
7 out of 10.
So, yeah.
Well, these people are going to come over.
I know that,
They need some money.
Yeah.
They need some food.
Yeah.
Well, that's a way to overwhelm the system. It's too many Americans are on the system. Well, now you want to give people free education, free health care. A lot of these illegal immigrants, they're coming up with the measles. They're not checking them for diseases.
Yeah.
In sanctuary states, California, Arizona, New York, all the ones that all these illegal immigrants are going, that's where you got the outbreaks at.
Yeah.
If the media was properly educating the public, no, you know what? You need to get the vaccination. They're telling you that you need to do that.
Yeah,
but if they were to secure the border or check them at the beginning, they would never make you get that vaccination. Okay, you're not concerned on stuff like that?
Yeah, no, obviously, yeah. That's just something to be concerned about.
There's some crazy stuff going on,
bro. There's a lot to be concerned about, honestly.
But look, I'm going to bet you don't have this conversation to talk to people like this, right?
Yeah.
I love you, dude. I'm only telling you. I'm not here to scare you. I'm not here to
up for like a new perspective.
Okay, it looks like people today in the Central Valley, some are concerned about illegal immigration and some don't care. And I think the ones that really don't care, they're the ones that are uneducated. They watch the mainstream media and they believe the lies of the left, of free education, free healthcare, and all these other government granted rights. But I think as Americans, if you're willing to go down that road, you have to understand eventually it all comes to an end. You have to look at Venezuela. That's where you're going to go down that road is socialism. It's collapsed every other society before us, and it's going to collapse America. You have to understand our country, our system of government is a system of checks and balances, and it's responsibility to its citizenry, and we have to start defending in America. If the media was doing their due diligence to properly educate people, I wouldn't be doing what I'm doing. So if you're not going to do everything in power to destroy life, liberty, and this country, you're going to do everything in power to destroy all three. Charlie the Box, the Patriot, Miscreant, and I'm out.
Hello there. Watch Charlie the Box before he's sent to a re-education camp.